The Rhaeti, Rhaetar, were a confederation of alpine tribes, whose language and culture may have derived, at least in part, from the Etruscans. From not later than California, 500 BC, they inhabited the central parts of present-day Switzerland, the Tyrol in Austria, and the alpine regions of northeastern Italy. The etymology of the name Rhaeti is uncertain. The Roman province of Rhaetia was named after this people. Ancient sources characterize the Rhaeti as Etruscan people who were displaced from the Po Valley by the Gauls and took refuge in the valleys of the Alps. But it is likely that they were predominantly indigenous alpine people. Their language, the so-called Rhaetian language, was probably related to Etruscan, but may not have derived from it. At least some of the Rhaeti tribes probably continued to speak the Rhaetian language as late as the 3rd century AD. Others were probably Celtic-speaking by the era of the Roman Emperor Augustus. The Rhaeti were divided into numerous tribes, but only some of these are clearly identified in the ancient sources. The Rhaeti tribes, together with those of their Celtic-speaking neighbors to the north, the Vindelici, were subjugated by the Imperial Roman army in 15 BC and their territories annexed to the Roman Empire. The Roman province of Rhaetia a Vindelicia was named after these two peoples. The Rhaeti tribes quickly became loyal subjects of the empire and contributed disproportionate numbers of recruits to the Imperial Roman army's auxiliary corps. Name etymology. The origin of the name Rhaeti is uncertain. It is not even clear if it derives from the endonym, a name that the Rhaeti used to describe themselves, or from the exonym, a name used by outsiders to describe the Rhaeti. It was suggested in the 19th century that Rhaeti is an exonym given to these tribes by the Gauls, derived from a supposed Celtic root rhaet, so that Rhaeti meant mountain people. The Roman geographer Pliny the Elder, writing in AD 70, suggests that the people were named after Rhaetus, their leader at the time of their supposed expulsion from the Po Valley. But this kind of eponym fabrication was commonplace in the Greco-Roman world and may be discounted. The most famous example is the legend that the city of Rome derives its name from Romulus, its supposed founder. If Romulus ever existed at all, then it is far more likely that he derived his own name from an existing place named Roma, rather than vice versa. The same applies to Rhaetus. It has also been suggested that the name Rhaeti may be connected with Rhaetia, a major goddess who was revered in northeast Italy and is attested in a number of inscriptions on votive tablets of the Venetian people. One Rhaetic votive tablet, from the same region, contains the word Rhaetis, which may refer to this deity. Origins. The earliest mention of the Rhaeti in surviving ancient sources is in the histories of Polybius, written before 146 BC. The Rhaeti, according to Pliny the Elder, were Etruscans driven into the Alps from the Po Valley by invading Gauls. This account of Rhaeti origins is supported by the Augustan-era Roman historian Livy. If this historiography is correct, then the displacement from the Po Valley would have taken place in the period 600–400 BC, when major migrations of Celtic tribes from Gaul resulted in the Celtization of that entire region. But the traditional migration theory, espoused by classical authors and, until the 1960s, by most modern scholars, is no longer considered the only possible explanation for sociolinguistic change. It is just as likely that the Rhaeti, if they spoke an Etruscan-like language, were alpine indigenes who had spoken it as long as, if not longer than, the Etruscans of Etruria, especially if, as most scholars believe, Etruscan represents the pre-Indo-European base language of Italy and the Alps. Alternatively, if the Alpine indigenes previously spoke a language unrelated to Etruscan, they may have adopted Etruscan through processes other than mass immigration, e.g., through cultural interchange with the Etruscans of the Po Valley, or as a result of elite transfer by an Etruscan elite that acquired political hegemony over the Alpine tribes. Ethno-linguistic affiliation. The Rhaetii are believed by many scholars to have spoken, originally at least, the so-called Rhaetian language, an extinct tongue known only from a series of inscriptions written in a variant of the Etruscan alphabet. This tongue is commonly regarded by most philologists to be related to, or at least strongly influenced by, Etruscan, a non-Indo-European language which is best documented in the central Italian region of Tuscany. The language has been called Rhaetian by linguists because it is assumed to have been spoken by the Rhaetii. It is possible, although unlikely, that the language dubbed Rhaetian by modern scholars had, in reality, no connection whatever to the people known to ancient Romans as the Rhaetii. Even if Rhaetian was the ancestral language of the Rhaetii, there is considerable uncertainty as to how widely Rhaetian was spoken among the tribes by the time of Augustus. In the Alpine region as a whole, there is evidence that the non-Celtic elements had, by the time of Augustus, been assimilated by the influx of Celtic tribes and had adopted Celtic speech. According to Livy, the sound of the Rhaetii's original Etruscan tongue had become corrupted as a result of inhabiting the Alps. This may indicate that at least some of the tribes lost their ancestral Rhaetic tongue to Celtic. Celticization also finds support in the Roman practice of twinning the Rhaetii with their neighbors to the north, the Vindelici, who are regarded by most historians to have been Celtic speakers. The territories of the two peoples were combined for administrative purposes from an early stage and eventually, under the Emperor Claudius, as the province of Rhaetia a Vindelicia. In addition, a pair of joint Rhaetorum a Vindelicorum auxiliary cohorts were established under Augustus. Further support for the hypothesis that the northern Rhaetii tribes converted to Celtic speech before the Roman imperial era is provided by the distribution of Rhaetian inscriptions. These have been found almost exclusively in northeastern Italy, South Tyrol, Trentino, and the Veneto region. None have been found in Switzerland, the other core Rhaetii region. The Rhaetii conscriptions indicate that Rhaetian survived as late as the 3rd century AD, suggesting that the Rhaetii tribes in this region at least may not have converted to Celtic speech. In addition, the abundance of Celtic toponyms and the complete absence of Etruscan place names in the Rhaetian territory leads to the conclusion that, by the time of Roman conquest, the Rhaetians were completely Celticized. During the centuries of Roman rule, the Rhaetii became predominantly Latin speakers. It has been suggested that a surviving relic of the Rhaetii's Latin speech is the Romansh language, one of the so-called Rhaeto-Romance languages. Romansh survives today in a few valleys of Swiss Canton Grisons. However, a Rhaetian origin for Romansh is uncertain, as Rhaeto-Romance languages appear most closely related to the Gallo-Romance group, strengthening the argument that the Rhaetii had adopted Celtic speech before Latinization. Territory. The evidence suggests that the original Roman district of Rhaetia a Vindelicia, as established under Augustus, had as its eastern border the river Enus from its confluence with the Danube as far south as, and then by the river Isarcus. Its northern border with the free German tribes was defined by the course of the upper Danube. On the west, Rhaetia a Vindelicia included the whole of Lake Constance and the upper Rhine valley, and then a long tract westwards along the upper Rhone valley as far as Lake Leman. To the south, its border with the Italian regionus of Gallia Transpadana and Venetia a Histria was roughly similar to the northern border of present-day Italy. The Vindelici were, according to Ptolemy, confined to the east of the river Lica, while west of that river, Upper Bavaria was inhabited by Rhaetii. A contrary view is that the whole region between the Danube and the Alps was occupied by Vindelici, with the Rhaetii confined to the Alps themselves. The latter view accords with Strabo, who records that the territory occupied by the Rhaetii tribes stretched from the upper reaches of the river Rhine in northern Switzerland to as far south as the cities of Como and Verona in northern Italy. The Rhaeti were bounded in the east by the Celtic Taurus I of Noricum and in the west by the Helvetii, tribes of the Rhaeti. Although the ancient sources concur in ascribing an Etruscan origin to the Rhaeti, they are less clear as to precisely which tribes attested in the region known as Rhaetia could be classified as Rhaeti. In addition, there are considerable discrepancies in the names of tribes given by the sources. Some locations of the tribes recorded are uncertain, although most have been established securely by place name and personal name evidence. Strabo names the Lepontii, Camunni, Cotuantii and Rucantii as Rhaeti tribes. Of these, the first two are listed with the same spelling in Augustus' inscription, while the latter two are probably the Cojuanites and the Rusinates respectively in Augustus. However, the inscription text appears to identify the Rusinates as one of the four tribes of the Vindelici recorded as conquered. Against Strabo, Pliny considers the Lepontii as a Celtic tribe akin to the Taurisi and classifies the Camunni as a tribe of the Euganei people of northeast Italy, together with the Tromplini of the neighboring valley, Val Trompia. However, neither of Pliny's comments is fatal to the identification of the Lepontii and Camunni as Rhaeti. The Lepontic language has been definitively classified as a distinct continental Celtic language. As for the Euganei, their linguistic classification is uncertain due to scanty evidence. It is possible that their speech was also related to Etruscan, possibly a subgroup of Ticinian languages. Alternatively, their language may have been Indo-European, akin to that of their close neighbors, the Celts or the Venetia. In addition, it appears that Rhaetia a Vindelicia was also inhabited by a number of non-Rhaetic tribes. The Bruni and Genorni are classified as Illyrian by Strabo, while a number of tribes in the region have plausible Celtic etymologies, e.g., Cachariges from Cachuum, Nantuates from Nantu respectively. The Tropium Alpium inscription contains the names of 45 Alpine tribes, taking those that inhabited the territories of Rhaetia a Vindelicia province and Venetia a Histria Regia of N. Italy, and eliminating those tribes considered probably Celtic by scholars. The following list of possible Rhaeti tribes results. Roman conquest. The Rhaeti, together with their probably Celtic neighbors to the north, the Vindelici, were subdued by the Roman Emperor Augustus's stepsons and senior military commanders Tiberius and Drusus in a two-pronged campaign in 15 BC, until California, AD 100, the region was garrisoned on its western edge by at least one Roman legion. In addition, Roman auxiliary forces and levis armatura were stationed there, but these forces were mainly for security against external threats, not internal unrest. Strabo reports that the Alpine tribes as a whole adapted easily to Roman rule and had not rebelled in the 33 years that had elapsed since the initial conquest. The Rhaeti were obliged to pay taxes to Rome. However, the combined territory was not initially organized as a full Roman province, but as a military district under a Roman equestrian officer, attested as praefectus of the Rhaeti, Vindelici in the Po Enine Valley. It was apparently not before Emperor Claudius that the district became a full province with the official name of Rhaetia a Vindelicia, while the Po Enine Valley was separated to join the province of Alps Graeae. Rhaetia was governed by an equestrian procurator. According to the epigraphic record, the early Julio-Claudian period of the Roman Empire saw the formation of at least 10 auxiliary infantry regiments from the Rhaeti tribes. This represents some 5,000 recruits, an onerous levy from sparsely populated alpine valleys. It suggests that the Rhaeti were strongly attracted to a career in the Roman military.